All right, so you've taken in a lot of information on how to use Pinterest for business, but you're not sure how to get started. In this video, I'm going to take all the information we've given you and help you put it together and get a roadmap to get you started with Pinterest for business. All right, everyone, I'm Sean with SEO Sorcerer. Welcome to part 5 of our Business for Pinterest course. This is the final part. In this one, we're gonna finalize your game plan and get you to where you start getting traffic to your blog or YouTube channel or wherever you're trying to get traffic from Pinterest today. In part 1, we talked about what you needed to do to optimize your Pinterest profile, how many boards you need, what you should have in your profile, your about me, your display name, everything like that. We covered it all. Hopefully you took care of that whenever you watched that. If not, go ahead and do that right now. There's a link in description. Seriously, go do it right now. In part 2, we talked about how many pins you should be creating per day. Basically, as many as you can. You need to be consistent. That was the main takeaway. Ideally, you'll want to do at least 10 pins per day, so that's a good number to start with. If you're not sure, then we just made that decision for you. 10. We're going with 10. 10 pins per day. But if you need that, there's also a link in the description if you need to watch that video and get a little more detailed information on how many pins you think you should be creating per day. In part 3, we looked into inspiration for pins, how to create aesthetically pleasing pins. That was more of a visual learning, so if you need to go back and take another look at part 3, there's a link below. And so go ahead and get that taken care of, and then we'll start creating pins. Part 4 was very helpful for people who were wondering, how am I going to create all these pins? You know, it's hard to commit to creating 70 pins a week, you know, when it takes you time to create each pin. In part 4, I laid it out for you, showed you exactly how to create the pins in batches of 4 or 5. That way, when you're creating 10 pins, you're actually creating 40 or 50. So that way, you know, much more streamlined process, and you'll be much more successful at keeping your pinning efforts consistently when you're able to crank out 4 or 5 pins at a time instead of just one. All right, now here we are. After the first 4 series, we finally arrived at part 5. So now what are we going to do in part 5? Part 5 is where we're going to take action. So here's what you're going to do. You're going to find 10 of your best pieces of content, and we're going to create 5 pins to each of them. I showed you in the last video how many you created. That way we'll have 50 pins. You're going to schedule them each 10 a day, whether you schedule them with Tailwind, whether you schedule them on the Pinterest website, or whether you just want to post them manually yourself. That's what we're doing today. I need you to do the first 50 pins, set them up 10 for each day, or if you commit to doing 25 pins a day, then this will just last you 2 days. I mean, 25 is a lot to start with, but if you're up for the task, that's even better. All right, so you get those pins going up, and this is the day. This is when we start bringing traffic to your business from Pinterest. Thank you for watching my Pinterest series. If you enjoyed it, go ahead and give me a thumbs up, subscribe, and ring that bell. Thanks for tuning in and making it all the way to the end. Stick around, and you'll see me soon with new content. Thank you again.